Hey, this is Joel. Welcome back to the Traveler Toolkit. I am setting in my EV, one that I've owned for almost 6 years now, today to tell you about an electric vehicle charger that I believe will help to reduce range anxiety. That's right. If you've ever taken a road trip in an electric vehicle, you know the anxiety of, will I find a charger? Will I run out of charge when I get there or before I get where I'm going? And I hope that this will quell some of those fears for you, because it is a 40 amp charger that will allow you to charge at almost 40 miles per hour when you find a 50 amp plug. I can't wait to show it to you, talk about all the features and benefits, go over the quality of the product itself, and share that with you in hopes that it might enable some of you to get further out there with your electric vehicles, do some traveling that maybe you thought was not possible before. So let's get to it. And before we open this up, I just want to say a quick thank you to WOLFBOX for being a dedicated partner of the channel since the beginning and for sponsoring today's video. All right, so let's go over everything that comes in the box with this unit. I'm going to start with the items that I won't be using or demonstrating in this video, because I plan to use this as a mobile charging solution. So I'm not going to use the mounting brackets, but you'll see they do give you these mounting brackets. Really well made. They feel like they're probably steel, angled steel, to mount it to a wall or to a post, should you so desire. This is your kind of cord hanger and your NACS port, which is what we have, not the J1772. Your NACS port would plug in here for storage. So this is just a kind of a plastic hanger there, as well as mounting screws and all sorts of anchors. They even give you some instructions for that. And then this is your template. You can lay this out to mark your holes for drilling. But if you were gonna mount it somewhere and leave it stationary, this is how you would do it. I intend to use this as a mobile charging solution. So we're not gonna use or demonstrate any of this in the video, even though I think it has great merit if you intend to put it in the spot and leave it there full time. So setting that aside, I'll also mention that it does come with this user manual, pretty standard, but important when you're dealing with something like this that does involve charging and electricity and all these things. Go through this, make sure you read everything. But what I want to focus on is this case itself and how I think it's a little nicer than it really needs to be. Most cases for this type of thing, basically an extension cord for your car, aren't this nice. It's got a hard side to it, not hard shell, but it is a harder shell, so you can knock on it. Comfortable handle with a Velcro top. And the nice thing about this case is that you can throw this in your trunk, not have to worry about anything messing up your charger in there. So I appreciate the nice case that it comes with. If we open it up here, we'll see what's inside and take a quick look at the unit itself. You'll see this is kind of a clamshell design here. We've got this mesh top that separates the actual charging unit from the cord. So just pulling this out, you will see this is our charging unit here. And we'll take a better look at this from different angles, but it's kind of a titanium, this feels like plastic, but looks like titanium box in here. Your display or readout up here. We have our, in this case, 50 amp output. So you can buy this in a 30 or a 50 amp output. I opted for the 50 because we're putting one of these on our new property with our cabin so we can plug in. This is also a common RV plug. We have a 50 amp RV and this will charge it a little bit faster. I believe the 50 amp is a level 2 charger, so we'll test how fast it does charge, but it's oriented in such a way that this can hang. We'll demonstrate that in just a minute, but this is the cable itself down below. You'll see we've got our NACS port here, plug. This is remarkably like a Tesla plug. It looks exactly like it, has the same button on it. I believe that button will open our charging door, and we'll get to all that in just a minute, but there is the roll of cable. So let's go ahead and hook this thing up, test it out, see how it works, and I'll give you my open and honest opinion. All right, so this is gonna be my use case. And I know what you're gonna say, this is not gonna be everywhere. There are not gonna be 50 amp ports just setting everywhere for you to use. But yes, there are gonna be some places where I will strategically have access to something like this. And if I have a charger like this, it enables me to extend my range or my stay in those places. One of those places will be my own property where I often go out to. It's 60, 70 miles often when I travel and I need to recharge if I'm there for multiple days. Even some Airbnbs that have EV chargers available will have them plugged into a 50 amp outlet. You can bring this along with you and take advantage of a plug like this. So we have a 50 amp outlet wired to the outside of a garage. We use this for an RV. So all we're gonna do is plug this bad boy in here and then we'll take a closer look at the readout on the WOLFBOX. All right, I know this might be a little difficult to see on camera. There may be some flickering, so just stick with me. But this is the readout on the WOLFBOX. I wanted you to see all this useful information on here. We have things like the temperature in the top left-hand corner, 68 degrees Fahrenheit height. We have the voltage underneath that. This is a 240 volt plug, 40 amps. Now I know it's a 50 amp plug, but it's putting out 40 amps of power. Then on the right-hand side, we have information about the charge. Once we get it going, those zeros will turn to actual numbers. We have amperage, we have kilowatts, we have a timer there, and then I believe that's kilowatt hours of output at the bottom. And so we will test all of those things out, but I wanted you to see this really handy readout that comes with the WOLFBOX so you can check your stats without having to look inside your vehicle. And now all we need to do is start to unravel our line and take it over towards the car. All right, so I backed my Tesla in this case. If you can't tell, this is a Tesla Model 3, so NACS is what we use. I backed it up closer to the outlet, but this gives you 25 feet of cable, so even if I had pulled into this spot, I could still reach the back of my vehicle from there. We've got plenty left over here to make sure that we get to the charging port, and in this case, we have a button right on the unit that we can press, and it should open that door, so let's go ahead and press that and see. There we go. And it's just as simple as plugging it in like we would with our branded Tesla charging cord at home. There we go. All right, so you will notice now the light has gone from a blue to a blinking green while we are charging. I want to try to give you a quick look at these stats if you can see them there. You can see if it'll focus that we've been charging for almost 4 minutes there. We're getting 0.58 kilowatt hours of power, charging at 39.98 amps, which is right at capacity for the 40 amp charger. But yeah, all the stats are displayed right there. That's really handy to be able to see. Hey, just a quick reminder, if you are interested in this product, I'm gonna leave a link in the description below for you. All right, so if we take a look inside here, we can see that we have 1 hour and 30 minutes remaining to full charge. I have my charge limit set to 80%. We're getting 39 miles per hour of charge. We've added a mile so far, we just started. We're at 40 amps and 233 volts. Everything's verified over here. We're at 190 miles and we're going up to about 225, I think is the 80 mile limit. But 39 miles added per hour of charge is much, much faster than you would get out of the standard travel charger that Tesla gives you. And while I'm well aware that 20 amps is less than 40 amps, I thought I'd pull out the travel charger that came with my Tesla. Here's our NACS port, looks a lot like the WOLFBOX, and our 20 amp just regular household outlet. I'm gonna plug this in just so we can compare and show you how many more miles per hour you'll get with something that is 40 amps versus 20. All right, plug it in here. Now let's check our Tesla app. All right, so we're plugged in with the regular Tesla travel charger. We've gone from about 2 hours with the WOLFBOX up to almost, yeah, just over 9 hours to fully charge to our 80% limit. And instead of getting 39 miles per hour, we are getting 4 miles per hour at 12 amps and 115 volts. So this is the power. This is the difference of a 40 amp charger level 2 versus just the travel charger that Tesla gives you. You could not recharge your car in an evening. You would only, while you sleep, get like 50 miles. That's what I used to get with this thing. So a big difference in what you can do. And while we have them both out here, I thought I would hold them side by side so you could see. This is the factory Tesla plug NACS, and this is the WOLFBOX. See how similar they are? In fact, the only thing you can really see different is the fact that this one says Tesla on it. The WOLFBOX does not. They have a similar button, similar size, similar shape, exact same size and shape. It's hard to really tell the difference. Obviously, the cord sizes are different gauges, different thickness. This is sending more amperage through it than this one here, but I trust the thickness of this cord, the quality of this cable, and I think it's really gonna do well as a travel charger to allow me to get quicker charges and more amperage. So now that we have unplugged and ended our session temporarily, I wanna show you a little bit about these buttons on the front. At first, it's not intuitive that they are buttons, but this is an amperage selector and this is a delay timer, which is what this little clock here is for. At first, I thought that would show us time elapsed on our charge, but it really is a delay timer. So you can tap this, and it's very hard to see on this camera, but you can tap this really gently and it'll delay it 1 hour, 2 hours, 3, 5, 6, 8, and then back to all the way up to 10 or even 12 hours and then back to 0, yeah. So you can delay the charging. You can plug in and delay your charging by up to 12 hours using that button. And this is the amperage button. If you hold this for 3 seconds, it will begin selecting or give you the option to select your amperage down to 8 and all the way back up to 40. I'm not 100% sure why you would want to change the amperage you're charging at, but you can. You can go back to 40, let it set there, and it will kick back at 40. So it's not intuitive to me that these are buttons. That's the only thing that's not intuitive about this. Out of the box, it comes in plug and play settings. So you can just plug in and start charging, but if you need to use delay or want to change your amperage, those two buttons are how you do it. So to me, the best thing about a product like this is that you can't mess it up. It's plug and play. This has all sorts of protections built into it. You know, it can charge down to like negative 22 degrees, super hot conditions, super cold conditions. It's got all the protections for overcharging, overheating, lightning strike, things like that. You don't have to worry about it. It's super high quality, high density electrical cable, and it's a level 2 charger, so you're gonna get maximum amount of protection and maximum amount of mileage out of it. WOLFBOX has been a really great partner for the last couple years as I've tested many of their products, and this is no exception to the quality that they generally put out. I'm really excited about what this brings into my world, the possibility to go places and take my electric car with me in different capacities and stay for longer stays because I have the ability on unique situations to charge it at a higher rate. And if you're getting 39, 40 miles per hour, that means that you could charge this car from 0 all the way back up in just an evening while you sleep. And that's really what you wanna be able to do, is run around all day on your range, charge up while you sleep, and have a full car when you wake up. So this really opens a lot of new doors if you get creative and know when and where you're gonna have access to 50 and even 30 amp outlets. And just for good measure, I thought I'd show you what it's like to put it back in the case it came with, because it's always annoying if these things don't go back in their case. We're gonna start by putting the larger unit underneath the mesh up top here, just kind of letting it feed down. Now remember, it does come with some of these Velcro straps, so I'm not sure we need them. You can just feed the cable into the case as you wind it. You have to kind of turn it to make sure it fits. But this way, you don't have to stick it in there once you're all balled up. If you're just rolling it back into the case as you're bringing it in. There we go. Just like that. And for me, I'm just gonna leave it like that. But you could take these Velcro straps and go around these ends that have a tendency to get a little wild, strap those down. Just like that, and you're good to go. Then the lid just closes like that. Pull your zipper out, zip it up, Velcro at the top, and you're good to go.
Look at that, it worked.
And while I know the haters and trolls like to come out in force when somebody posts a video about an EV or a Tesla and tell us how stupid they are and how much they hate us, I just will say from my perspective that after owning this vehicle for over 5 years, I've got 60,000 miles on it. It's been an extremely responsible financial choice. It's already paying for itself in 60,000 miles. The only thing I've spent money on is a new set of tires, one new set of tires. And with charging solutions like this, I'm able to drive a vehicle like this across the country. I've taken several trips that are 8, 9, 10 hours long, charging at hotels, charging at Airbnbs, things like that. And devices like this make that possible and allow me to save 75 or 80% on fuel costs, which is what it would cost if I drove a regular car. Not to mention wear and tear. This vehicle drives exactly like it did the day I got it. Not something you can say for most gas-powered vehicles. And so while I know there are pros and cons to gas and electric, and I'm not here to make a statement about any of those, I think with accessories like this WOLFBOX charger, you can find ways to stay out longer, take more sustainable trips, not from a planetary perspective, but just sustainable meaning you can go further in electric vehicles. You know, one of the things that I've not yet been able to do is go to a national park in an electric vehicle because there's not a lot of places to charge. Something like this might enable me to if I can find Airbnbs with 50 amp outlets and charging ports and things like that. So I like that it opens up new possibilities and portability to areas of the country that may not have superchargers or electric vehicle chargers just sitting around ready for you to use. So thanks for joining me as we explore one more way to help you get out there and stay out there longer in your travels. As always, I will leave a link to this product in the description below if you are interested in checking that out for yourself. My name is Joel, this is the Traveler Toolkit, and I'll see you in the next video.